Hello, welcome to Literary Life, and welcome to this week's books I'm going to be reading. I'm actually really excited about this week because I have a wide array of types of books, and some of them haven't even come out yet, or one of them. The first book I'm going to be reading is Perfect Tunes by Emily Gould. This book is coming out in April, so next month. I won this in a giveaway, and I'm really excited to read it and share it with you in case it is already on your radar. You can hear the review next week, or if it should be on your radar, we'll find out. So essentially, what is this book about? This is New York's Greenwich Village, and our main character, Emily, is a musician, and she has this really intense few-month love affair with a fellow by the name of Dylan, and I can't believe I just used the word fellow. I'm reading a book right now set in the 50s. I believe that. Okay, so anyway, he ends up passing away, and you jump forward 14 years, and our main character has a daughter who is starting to ask a lot of questions about her father, Dylan. And essentially, our main character starts to go back and contact his family, trying to give her daughter the connections and the history and the relationship she's interested in. And basically, that just brings up a lot of things that she was trying to essentially leave behind from the early parts of her life. So Perfect Tunes by Emily Gould. So the next book I'm going to be reading this week is my beautiful edition of Pine. This is sort of that gothic mystery that is set in this remote village, and the town is kind of quirky. They're very much isolated, and it sounds like they have a lot of their own customs, but essentially people are starting to pop up dead. And so there we have it. They got to figure out what's going on. It is described as kind of a gothic thriller or gothic horror. So I am really intrigued to read this one. And this book will be a chapter chats video coming, or videos coming in the future week as well. So watch out for them if you're interested. So the next book I'm going to be reading this week came out last year, and that was The Invited by Jennifer McMahon. So essentially, this book is about a couple who decides to leave suburbia and move out into a rural area and build the home of their dreams. The woman in the couple, or the one of them, is a retired, I think, or past history teacher. So she essentially uncovers a lot of history related to the land on which they're building, about a family where the females died for like three generations. And she is using, as they're building their home, because she is such a history buff, she is using like old materials that she's finding in the town. So like parts of an old schoolhouse, the parts of the old mill, to incorporate them into the home her and her husband are building. Essentially lending to inviting in some of the ghosts that leads to menace in their brand new built home. So sounded very creepy and very interesting for me. So The Invited by Jennifer McMahon. So the next book I'm going to be reading is also a book by Jennifer McMahon, The Winter People. And this book is about a town where a woman has grown up, but she essentially wants to leave this town and kind of get out. The town is known for a string of disappearances. One of the most famous is a girl from the early 1900s, I believe, by the name of Sarah. So our main character, you know, growing up in this town, has her own daughter, and essentially, like I said, wants to kind of move on, and then her daughter goes and disappears. And our main character finds in her daughter's possessions a diary that belonged to one of the most famous cases, the girl I mentioned in the early 1900s who had disappeared. So essentially it leads to sort of a more ominous, what is going on, and is there more to these ghost stories and legends than our main character originally thought? Okay, and lastly for this week is Stillhouse Lake by Rachel Cain. This is the first book in a trilogy, and I believe that one of you put this on my radar like a year ago, and I'm finally getting to them thanks to the library. But anyway, Stillhouse Lake is about a woman with two children who finds out, thanks to a car accident, that her husband is actually a serial killer. He is incarcerated now, And but that's caused a lot of upheaval in her life because essentially, she's people come at her because of the crimes, the vicious crimes her husband committed. So she essentially changes her identity and moves herself and the children to Stillhouse Lake, a remote area, hoping to just be able to rebuild and live a new life without anyone knowing who she was married to. Lo and behold, body turns up in the lake, and then a string of threatening letters arrive, essentially placing her and her children in harm's way. Somebody knows who she is, and somebody is threatening her. So again, this is the first part in the trilogy. So if you're intrigued, a little bit of a spoiler, I will be reading the other two probably the week after, so I can blow right through these. Hence, I'm planning this one for the very end of the week so I can roll right into those. So Stillhouse Lake by Rachel Cain, one of three. Okay, so that is it for this week, guys. As always, thank you for watching. Hit subscribe and join us if you're not already. And until then, let's go read some books. Happy reading.